Welcome to WebStyle Plus. We can get the screen width and height as pixel values using pure CSS. It involves property CSS add rule and trigonometric functions. So I have got this div that we will append those values to. To do that, we will use property CSS add rule. So inside styles, I will use this wful and hful. Our custom CSS properties here or variables we are declaring with specific characteristics such as syntax, inheritance, and default value. We initialized window width and height custom variables using full viewport height and width. Width 100VW, height 100VH. More on property add rule here. The property CSS add rule allows developers to explicitly define CSS custom properties, allowing for property type checking and constraining, setting default values and defining whether a custom property can inherit values or not. Custom property registration. So here syntax angle inherits false initial value 45 degree. This is exactly what we did here. Syntax length in our case inherits true, and for initial value 100VW, for width and for height 100VH. Then here we are declaring two more variables, sWidth and sHeight, to calculate actual screen width and height in pixels but without px unit. This is a trigonometric function. Here this function is providing unitless values, so we can use them inside any formula. It's using 100VW and 100VH here for width and height. Now we have got this container. So I can display those values in pseudo element. For pseudo element, I used content. And then counter W, counter H, where W and H will be screen width and height calculated above. Basically, we are dynamically inserting the values of the custom properties W and H as text in the after pseudo element. And because of counter reset, these values will update on screen resize. No need for JavaScript here. In fact, we can register length and set its value, then find out the size in pixels, and then convert it to numeric value by using this function. This is the whole thing, and this is we get. If we resize the window, it responds accordingly and accurately too. I needed such solution in a very critical app, and a colleague shared this technique with me. Whoever wrote this is a CSS genius. Okay, I hope it helped. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see you in the next one.